Hello everyone. Welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create and customize a brand in BoldSign. A brand serves as an identity, allowing easy recognition through a unique logo and color scheme. This professional touch leaves a strong impression on recipients. BoldSign offers branding features that enable customization of signer pages and emails to align with your company's brand identity. Customize your brand by incorporating your company's logo, adjusting the background and button color themes, specifying the from name in emails, and more. Multiple brands can be created, and anyone can be set as default. Senders can choose the desired brand when creating a new document. These branding configurations are global and applicable to all the users in your account, impacting the recipient experience for all documents sent from your account. Let's create a new brand now. I am creating this brand for my new startup company. And I understand the significance of branding to establish a strong market presence. By customizing my branding elements, I can create a unique identity that aligns with my business goals and resonates with my target audience. To begin with, in the BoldSign web app, I expand the settings and select the branding option. I create a new brand by clicking the Create New Brand button and enter my brand name, Cube Flakes. Here is an option to set the brand as default, but I leave it as it is for now. The remaining options are classified as general and advanced. In the general section, I add my logo, enter an email display name, select colors, and toggle the option to hide the BoldSign branding. I now browse and add my brand logo from my local drive. Then I enter my email display name, sender name within the curly braces, followed by from and my company name. This will be visible as the email from name. You can customize this as desired. I select the email background color, primary button color, and primary button text color to match my brand logo. I can directly select colors from the color picker or enter hexadecimal values for each. Then I opt to keep the BoldSign branding toggle disabled. Moving to the advanced section, I select how the final signed document is to be delivered to the signers. It can either be an attachment in the email or a link to download the document. The attachment option is the default, and I leave it unchanged. Next, if I enable the Combine Audit Trail option, the completed document and audit trail can be combined into a single document. If I want to add custom legal terms, I can enable the respective toggle and add them. If a custom legal term is added, signers must accept these terms and conditions before they proceed to sign the document. I now add custom legal terms to my brand. When the time zone option is enabled, the specified time zone will be used for the audit trail document and the date signed field. Additionally, there is an option to redirect a URL, which is helpful when I want to redirect my signers to a specific page once the document signing process is completed. At the end of the advanced section is an option to create custom form fields. The Allow Users to View Standard Form Fields option is enabled by default and cannot be unchecked until custom form fields are created and shared. To create custom form fields, use the Configure Custom Form Fields button. Once a custom field is created, you can enable the Share Custom Field option to share it within your organization. However, in my case, I don't need any custom fields, so I leave all these options as they are for now. I check the preview of both the general and advanced sections. In the general section, see the email and signer page views, along with the desktop and mobile modes. I can preview the custom legal terms page in desktop and mobile modes in the advanced section. Once I'm satisfied, I save the brand, and a new brand is successfully created. Using the context menu, I can set one of my created brands as default. However, only one brand can be set as default. I can delete or copy the brand ID in the context menu if needed. To edit the brand, I click the context menu and select the Edit Brand option. It takes me to the Edit Brand page, where I can edit any of it and save the changes. Now, let me show you how to create a document with the newly created brand. I click Create New and select the Create New Document option. On the Prepare Document page, after adding the file and relevant details, I scroll down to the Document Settings section. There, I select the created brand. If I have set it as default, it will be automatically selected, otherwise, I can select the brand from the drop-down menu. I select Cube Flakes as the brand and proceed to the next page, where I add the relevant form fields and send the document out for signature. Now, let me switch to the signer side and check the signature request email. As you can see, the email has been customized with the logo, from name, and colors I had added to the brand. I click the Review and Sign button and navigate to the signing page. When signing the document, you will be prompted to review and accept the terms and conditions, including any custom terms that have been added. This ensures that all parties are aware of and agree to the specified terms. The UI displays the specified logo and colors. The signing process is now completed. When you download the audit trail document, the branding will be prominently displayed. This ensures consistent visibility of the brand identity throughout the audit trail. Furthermore, the custom legal terms you have added will be included at the end of the audit trail document. This way, you can create and customize a brand for the business in BoldSign. If you found this video useful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Thank you for watching and stay tuned to our channel for more BoldSign tutorial videos.